Welcome students, I am back with a new tutorial. Today I'll be teaching you how to make an animated windmill. So what you are seeing here on the screen, I just made a demo windmill. You could see the sprite is moving and with these numbers I can control the speed. Suppose I am clicking on 2, the speed is more. 3, you will see speed has increased, 4 and 5. So the coding is very easy. You could see here when I am clicking upon 0, and when I click on 0 now, speed is 0, it stopped. So how to do the coding? So directly I am taking you on the coding window. So firstly, before the coding, we have to design all these things, and this fan what you are seeing, it's not available in Sprite, so we have to design this fan also. So dear students, now I'll be teaching you how to do the coding in which you will learn how to animate the windmill along with the controls. So first of all, the fan sprite is not available by default, so we have to paint that sprite. So this is the default sprite, I'll delete it. Now I'll create my own sprite. So I'll just click here, choose a sprite, and then I'll click upon paint here. So I'll just click it, and after clicking, I am here in this window which allows me to design a sprite. So simply I'll select this rectangle tool, and then with the help of rectangle tool, I'll just change the color, which I can just select any color. Suppose I want to take this one, and then after this I'll just make a rectangle. And then as I'll select, you could see here in between the one circle is there. You could see here one circle is there in between. So it allows me to align my rectangle in middle. So after this, I just decrease the width. And then little bit I want to reshape, just to give the shape of a blade. Because in my fan, I want to make two blades. Although there can be three also, but I just want to make two. So this is the reshape option here. I'll just click upon this. And then from here, I can just make it like this. And from here also, just to give the shape of a blade. So I hope this is clear. Here also we can do little bit changes. Once the shape has been given, you can just click here in select, and then at the bottom there is one rotate option. I think you are not able to see. I'll just make it a little smaller. So firstly, for making two blades in a fan, I have to copy and paste it. So there is one option here, copy. I can just click upon copy and then click upon paste. So you could see here two blades, and at the bottom there is the rotate button. I just rotate it like this, and then I can place it here in the middle. You could see here it's been designed, and then you can make it more better comparing to me. And then if I want in between one circle, I can add like this. Color I can take any. Okay, so means a rough design of my sprite is ready. Then I'll be back in my coding window. You could see here my sprite is ready. Like this you can design your own sprite if that sprite is not available. Now little bit size I want to change, I'll just make it to 70, let's see. So I hope this is okay for me. And then I want to add one building here. So that also I have to take one sprite. I'll click upon sprite, then here building I have to select. This is the building. this is. So I'll just select the building, and by default the building is like this. Now from here you can select the type of building by changing its costume. So how to do that? Just select the building from here, this sprite, and after this you have to go to the costume there. Here you have to go, and then from here you could see different costumes. So it will be changed according to this. You can change whatever you feel is okay for you. Suppose I want this one, so I'll just take this one, okay, and then I'll be back in the coding window and I'll place this sprite on top of this. So I hope till here it's been very much clear to you. Now to do the simple animation, what I can do, just a simple animation. So I can just start the coding. Directly I'll go to event. Here I have gone in event, then when clicked, and then I can choose the loop. For example, I have taken forever loop. This is a simple coding. Controls I'll teach you how to add. So here if I want to rotate my fan, simply I'll choose motion block. Under motion block, suppose I am taking turn. So this coding I have added in my sprite one, that means which is the fan. So if I just click on play, you could see here my fan is been animated, it started working. So in this way you have learned how you can design your own sprite and you can animate. Now this is a simple animation. Now I'll teach you how to add controls. Suppose I want to control the speed of the fan. So how can you add that? So my first part of this animation is over. Now the second part starts, in which I'll teach you to add controls, and I'm also wanting to add the variable. So I'll stop this. Even this one I'll take it out because I don't need this now. Now I have to do little changes here. Firstly, I have to add some more sprites. Just for adding different sprites, I have to click here, choose a sprite. And here from here, I want to add numbers. You could find at the bottom the numbers. Suppose I want 0. This will act as a control, okay, and then I'll do it again. I want some other numbers also, 1, okay. So I hope it's been clear. Now to do the coding for this. Simple, if suppose I am clicking upon 0, or this one, this sprite. So I'll go to events. When this sprite is clicked, okay, then what it should do? When this sprite is clicked, so this I have choose from events. So I want to do the coding for this. But before doing that, I want to create one variable. So for variable, you very well know that you have to click on variable block from here, and here I'll create my own variable. I'll make the name of that variable is speed. Click on OK. So I'll use the set command. The speed, set speed is equal to 0. Only this much coding I have added in this. When this sprite is clicked, set speed is equal to 0. That means speed is my variable. Now this I'll copy and paste on all of my sprites where 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 4, 5, 3 I have left. So I'll add that also. So it's okay now. So this control, what I've showed you, this I'll paste on each and every sprite. That means the numbers. So I'll drag it, simply left mouse button, drag it, then drag it to 2, drag it to 3, 4, 5. So now this I have already done the coding for 0, that means the 0 sprite. Now for 1, only the change what I'll do, when this sprite clicked, set speed is equal to 1 according to the number. Then when clicked upon 2, then speed is equal to 2. Now when clicking upon 3, speed is equal to 3. When 4, speed is equal to 4. And when 5, this has been missed. Then speed is equal to 5. Okay, so this much we have done. We have copied this coding, only 2 line coding, to each and every sprite separately. Now the coding for sprite begins. The fan. So in the forever loop only we will do. Now we have to use if command. Here is the if command under control. Now what we want to check? We want to check the speed actually, the variable which we have made. So along with this I need operator also, is equal to operator. So I'll choose the is equal to operator from here. Yes, this one. So I want to check the speed, that if the speed is equal to 0, then what it should do. So I'll do here, I'll just select speed from here, I'll just drag it. If speed, now speed is a variable, or earlier we have set the speed. I'll just show you once again. Like if it is, we are clicking upon 0, so we are setting the speed here 0. So if we have selected 0 and if the variable speed is 0, then what it should do, then it should not turn a fan sprite. So I'll give the command here, turn 0. That means it should not turn only. So I hope this command is very much clear to you. The same way, if we'll duplicate it, if speed is equal to 1, if speed is equal to 1, then what it should do? Suppose then it could start with a very less speed, suppose 2.5. I'll just check it. So suppose I'll click upon 0, nothing is going. If I'll click upon 1, you could see here it started moving. That means our coding is okay. But when we are clicking on 2, nothing is going on. Okay. So I have to do the coding for that also. So I'll duplicate it again and again. If speed is equal to 1, if speed is equal to 2, then let it be, we can make it to 5. If speed is equal to 3, then we can make it to 10. That means turning 10 degrees. It's like this. Again duplicate. If speed is equal to 4, then 20 degree. And one more. If speed is equal to 5, then 30 degree. So let's try this. Everything we have to put inside the forever loop. Now I'll run this. 0 means stop. 1, 2, the speed is increased. I'll just make it a little bigger. 1. 1 slow, 2 faster, 3 more faster, 4, and then 5. So I hope the coding is very much clear to you. It stopped now. I'll again zoom it. So I hope it's very much clear. I've done nothing. I've just copy and paste. Only I'm checking the speed. And from where the speed is being controlled, it's been controlled from different sprites here. So I'll stop my recording here only. It's working fine. So if you have any problem, please comment at the bottom and wait for my new tutorial. Till then, bye.